determine the direction of flow? Direction of flow is along the streamline, yes or no? Right? So please write down tangent to the streamline. Tangent to the streamline is the direction of flow. Okay? So if I know the streamline, which streamline it is, I can just draw the tangent and I can tell you at this point the direction of flow is this. Okay? Simple. Alright? Now streamline gives you more information than just telling you about the direction of flow. Okay? Let us see how. For example, if you take, suppose you have a streamline like this, can two streamlines intersect? Reason? Suppose they intersect at point A, two streamlines intersect, then what does it mean? I can draw two tangents at point A, tangent to this streamline and tangent to that streamline. So which velocity it is? A particle cannot have two velocities at a particular point. So if they intersect, you will have two tangents along the two streamlines. Okay, which is again the definition of streamline itself. Fine? So that is why two streamlines will never intersect. Alright? Okay? How do you think turbulent flow might be happening? There is no unique path when it comes to turbulent flow. A particle might be going like this. Similar particle starting from here could follow a different path. Okay, so there is no fixed path. The intermixing is so much. Okay, you can't determine the path of a particle in a turbulent flow. Okay, so you cannot have any scientific theory as such to describe the turbulent flow. The most of the study in turbulent flow is statistical. You just observe and then correlate. Okay, I have observed this earlier, so if such kind of scenario again happens, then this is what will happen. Such kind of study will be there in turbulent flow. Not in our syllabus, you don't need to worry about it. Just I thought I could tell you, since we were discussing about laminar, so turbulent flow also. Now, I was talking about the information given by the streamline flow. So suppose this is a pipe. Clearly this is bigger cross section, this is bigger and that is smaller. And this is not the entire pipe, by the way. Every time I draw a pipe, I am not drawing the entire pipe. It is a part of a bigger pipe. Fine. Don't confuse with that this is the entire pipe. No. Okay. Now, if I draw a streamline starting from here, then this will be there. Now, there are infinite particles, right? So I can draw those many number of streamlines. Now tell me one thing, where do you think the velocity of the fluid is more? Here, at A2 velocity is more. Okay, and at A2 number of the streamline per unit area is also more. Density of streamline is more. Okay, so density of streamline gives you an indication of the magnitude of the velocity. Please write down that the number of streamline per unit area, number of streamlines per unit area is proportional to number of streamlines per unit area is proportional to the magnitude of the velocity. So now using streamline, I found out the direction as well as magnitude. Got it? Okay? So this is what the streamline flow is. We are not going to go back to the definition of streamline flow going forward. Alright? Any doubts on the definition of streamline flow, what it is? No? Okay. Now let us try to apply those two concepts that we have discussed initially. One was conservation of mass, another was work energy theorem. Alright, so let us take it one by one. First, I will apply conservation of mass. Write down. Conservation of mass in fluid dynamics is also referred as continuity equation or continuity theorem. Okay. Alright, so here is a pipe, let us say. This cross-section area is, let's say, A1, and that cross-section area is, let's say, A2. Okay? Now, other parameter also given. It's a part of a bigger pipe, by the way. Other parameters are given like this. The fluid enters with velocity V1 from here, and it goes from here with velocity V2. Achha, I forgot one thing. You guys have got your UT marks, right? I should have started the discussion with that. How many of you, it was out of?
25.
How many of you 25? 25! Good. Only one? Okay, how many of you above 20? Are about 20 I am saying. Only 2. What happened? Was it difficult? Okay, super girl. Huh? I am asking you, is she human or not? She can do it. Anyway, so the paper was difficult, is it? Lengthy. Paper was lengthy. Okay. Okay. And the, what are the chapters came? Okay. Okay, next physics test, please do well. Right. Anyways, so this is a scenario, and let's say density of the fluid is rho. Why I'm writing density here? Because till now I have been using density and pressure to define the property of the fluid, so I'll be using that terminology only. Okay, so this is the situation that is happening. Okay, now tell me, suppose in 1 second, 1 kg mass goes in 1 second, so in 1 second, how much mass will go out? 1 kg only? No. More than 1 kg will come out?
No.
Okay, wait. How many of you say only 1 kg will come out? Okay, how many of you say more than 1 kg? Okay, suppose A2 is more than A1, then what will happen? Lesser mass. Ajay, tell me one thing, guys. Wait. Suppose they are different. Suppose 1 kg is coming in and 3 kg is going out every second. Every second 2 kg is generated inside the pipe. Is it possible? The pipe generates 2 kg every second. Not possible? Suppose 5 kg goes in and only 1 kg goes out. So inside the pipe 4 kg is getting stored every second. Is it possible? No. So same 1 kg that is going in, same 1 kg will go out in 1 second. Are you getting it? But what if the pipe is empty? What if pipe is empty, pipe doesn't have water initially, then what will happen? Initially nothing will come out. First it will store the water inside the pipe. Once it is full, then whatever comes in from here, it will reject from there. Are you getting it? So we are not talking about the scenario when the pipe is empty. We are talking about the that scenario where pipe is completely filled. Okay? And that is the scenario we are going to discuss here. So we have determined that rate of mass that is entering from the left hand side should be equal to the rate of mass that is exiting from the right hand side. Does this make sense? Okay. Now, let us say in DT time, DT is a very very small time, right? In DT time, how much the water that is entering from left hand side will travel inside? Velocity into time. Velocity is V1 and time is DT. So distance travel will be V1 DT. Right? So let us say that it travels inside this distance, which is equal to V1 DT. Got it? Now tell me, how much is this mass which has gone inside? What is the mass of that? Okay, what is the volume of that? Tell me. A1 into V1 DT. It is like a cylinder. It is like a very thin cylinder. The area of cross section into height is the volume. So volume that has entered is area A1 into V1 DT. So mass will be that into rho. That into rho, right? So dm1 which has entered in dt time is a1 v1 dt into rho. Fine. So I am getting dm1 by dt is equal to rho a1 v1. So by the way, I am assuming that the fluid is incompressible. Otherwise, density will not remain uniform. Okay? Yes. No, non-viscous we are not assuming here right now. Okay? We are assuming that fluid is incompressible. Put it right down in the bracket, that assumption is fluid is incompressible. Density remains uniform. Same thing may not be valid for the air. Okay? Now, similarly, suppose V2 is the velocity here. Let's say it goes out, so this much water will go out, so this much distance will be V2 dt, right? The rate of water or the fluid that is coming out is rho into A2 into V2, yes or no? Okay, now these two are equal. The mass that is entering from the left hand side should be equal to mass that is exiting from the right hand side per unit time. Okay, so when you equate these two, you are going to get rho A1 V1 equal to rho A2 V2. This is same as A1 V1 being equal to A2 V2. Okay, got it? Now tell me, where have we used the fact that we are talking only about the laminar flow? Have you used that anywhere? This velocity is an sort of average velocity. Okay? No, no. This is not the particle velocity. Particles may still have a different velocity. This is like an average velocity. We have not used that assumption. So this continuity equation is valid for any kind of flow. Please write down. Continuity equation is valid for any kind of flow. And what if the fluid is compressible? Then
density.
Density will change. So the continuity equation will become rho 1 A1 V1 is equal to rho 2 A2 V2. Fine. If you're taking a compressible fluid, then rho 1 A1 V1 equal to rho 2 A2 V2. Okay? Yes. Any kind of flow. Conservation of mass is valid for any kind of flow. Isn't it? Do you think conservation of mass depends on what kind of flow it is? No, right? It should not. Any doubt? Okay, so this is continuity equation. Alright?